नेक्स्ट वी हैव इज एरर्स इन मेजरमेंट. द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड एरर इज डिविएशन फ्रॉम द ट्रू वैल्यू. वट एवर मेजरमेंट वी मेक इट हैज ए वन परफेक्ट आंसर. एनी अदर आंसर्स विच आर नॉट परफेक्ट दे आर टेंड टू पॉसेस द एरर. लेट अस सी व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ एरर. इट कैन बी ऑल्सो सेड एज इनएक्यूरेसी इन मेजरमेंट. एरर्स दे आर क्लासिफाइड एज वन आर सिस्टमैटिक एरर्स एंड अदर वन इज रैंडम एरर्स. Let us see what are systematic errors. Systematic errors are errors which arise due to some specific reason. They are always in one direction. Always in one direction in the sense they are always either positive or always negative. But cannot be positive negative together. It keeps on changing. These are errors. They are due to some specific reason which may not be able to be identified. What are the different types of systematic errors? So different type of systematic errors are instrumental error. There will be a problem in the instrument. Instrument may have become old. The lines on the instruments, markings on the instruments might not be able to read properly. Other one are procedural errors. Procedural error, or we can also call it as a experimental error. These are due to wrong practices that we use. Let us say I want to measure the length. Then as soon as I keep the scale, my eyes should be parallel to the reading. If the eyes are not parallel, then there may be an error in the measurement of the length. Personal errors. Personal error may involve the mood swing. May involve a disturbance from the neighbor sources or any such disturbances are called as personal error. The next other classification of the error is random errors. Now random errors, this can be measured. These are due to unpredictable situation. So let us see how these random errors there are is due to any situation. So let us see what can be done about these random errors. Random errors can be worked upon and can be minimized. So let us say how do we estimate the random error. Estimation of errors. So let us say if we have A1, A2, A3. AN readings maybe of any experiment, maybe this belong to time, maybe this may be length measured. Let us have measured the length of this page multiple times. Then true value means the perfect value of this length of this page, which is denoted by A bar, is A1 plus A2 plus A3 up to AN, the average of all the readings. This is how I get true value, the perfect value. You have to repeat this experiment multiple times. The more number of times you measure the length, the better, the accurate will be the true value. This is true value, or you can also call it as absolute value. Means this is the only perfect value. Any word you can use. Now, error in individual measurement. Let us say in the first measurement we have error A1, that is true value minus measured value. So there will be some difference between this true value and this. So that is called as a error in first reading. Error in first measurement. Similarly, delta A2 will be A bar minus A2. This is error in second measurement. And similarly, I will get error in nth measurement. All these errors all these errors when we add modulus of A1, A2, it should be taken positive irrespective of the sign up to AN divided by N. If we take average of this individual measurement, then the value we get is average absolute error. This is average absolute error. First we got the absolute value or a true value, then this is the average absolute error. This is in the steps, in the sequence, so please remember average absolute error. Now with the help of this, we can represent our reading as A1 plus or minus delta A, A2 plus or minus delta A. That means every reading will have error which may be added or may be subtracted from it. Let us say, for example, I say the length of this page. Length of this page, if its true value is 32.89 centimeters, right? Then, and if I calculate average absolute error as 0.09, then I can write down the values as, let us say the first reading represents 32.00 centimeters, second reading represents 31.29 centimeters. So it can be written as A1 will be 32.00 plus or minus the random error. Here also it can be written as 31.29 plus or minus random errors. Means its value will swing by this amount. It can be maximum. So this one, when you add plus 0.09, so this is the maximum value. And when you subtract 0.09, this is the minimum value. So your value will swing between these two values. That is how the physical quantities are noted. From this, next we find out is relative fractional error. Relative fractional error, that is denoted by the delta A, that is average absolute error upon the true value. This is average absolute error upon true value. And from this we get percentage error or percentage fractional error. So that is again simple, percentage error, we can say delta A into 100, or you can replace the value of delta A. So this is how the random errors work. We get a true value or absolute value. From absolute value we calculate error in individual measurements. Based on the errors in individual measurement, we get an absolute, average absolute error. With that average absolute error, we can calculate relative fractional error and then the percentage error. This part shows how the readings are represented in the terms of science or in physics. Readings can neither be accurately stated this way, they are stated as this plus or minus 0.9.